Hello, I'm Professor Illana Gozes, and I'm the corresponding senior author on an article called Activity-Dependent Neuroprotective Protein Deficiency, Model Synaptic and Developmental Phenotypes of Autism-like Syndrome. This study is in collaboration with many of my students, with McGill University in Canada, and with Biosev in the Czech Republic. We discovered activity-dependent neuroprotective protein, ADNP, about almost 20 years ago, and we found it to be essential for brain formation, and we also discovered a very small fragment of ADNP, NAP, or NAP-VSIPQ, that enhances the endogenous ADNP activity. The major function that is performed by NAP is actually an increase in dendritic spine formation in vitro, and this is associated with NAP ability to bind to microtubule end-binding protein and enhance microtubule dynamicity. It also enhances ADNP binding to microtubule end-binding protein and again to enhance microtubule dynamicity. Now we asked if this is also apparent in animals, in vivo. And to ask this question, we created a novel mouse model, which is ADNP haploinsufficient that also expresses GFP in neuronal membranes. And what we found is that these mice, there is a reduction in dendritic spine formation if they are haploinsufficient, and when treated with NAP intranasally and also by injection, we actually see an increase in dendritic spine formation, normalization of dendritic spine formation. Here you see the hippocampus. And the other aspect that we looked at is also immature shaft synapses that we labeled with PSD95, postsynaptic density 95, and we saw an increase in immature pathogenic synapses in the haploinsufficient animals that was corrected by NAP treatment. And the corrections was observed both in males and in females, and as you can see here from the slide, the phenotype was a little more severe in the males, more pathogenic, significantly more pathogenic synapses, which were corrected by NAP treatment. And when we looked at the cerebral cortex, we saw the same as we saw in the hippocampus. Here again, the phenotype was a little bit more severe in the male, and again, was completely corrected by NAP treatment. So we asked also, is this reflected also in gene expression? So we measured about 93 different genes that we saw by complete RNA sequencing. We saw many, many genes that changed. We looked at, we gathered like 93 genes and we looked at them all together in the hippocampus, cortex, and also in the spleen. And what we found is that two major genes were changing, kind of assembling around them many other genes in a network. And one gene that ADNP and NAP regulate is PSD95. So not only at the protein level, but also at the gene level. It's also called DLG4, as you see here. And another one is ACT1, which is associated with tissue growth, and especially the brain. So this is very important. And when we look specifically at specific genes, that both the ADNP genotype and also NAP regulates and corrects, we saw genes in the hippocampus, in the cortex, and also in the spleen, and meaning that the spleen is also a player here, and NAP may protect against also inflammatory. And it happens also in the young animal in 27 days, and also in 3 months. All the animals. I have to say that here, initially we gave NAP by injection, and then we gave NAP when the animals were weaned, we gave it by intranasal administration daily. And what you see here is we looked also at developmental milestones. So many of the ADNP, all the ADNP children are actually slow in development. They have developmental delays. So we looked to see whether the mice mimic this phenotype. And what we saw is, for example, vocalization. So the ADNP children can be delayed in language acquisition, and some of them, unfortunately, don't speak. And when we looked at the mice, they also were delayed in vocalization. They had less vocalization. And when we treated with NAP, we enhanced these haploinsufficient mice and they behave, we normalize them to a degree. And similarly, some developmental milestones were also inhibited. Most significantly, negative geotaxis was inhibited slower in development, and when we treated with NAP, we corrected it. And another facet that we looked, another characteristic that we look at was growth. And so the children are short in stature. So we looked at growth in the haploinsufficient animals, and it was delayed in the haploinsufficient animals as compared to normal animals. And then we also looked at gait, namely motor activities, walking of the mouse, which is delayed in the ADNP children. And what we saw here is that the haploinsufficient, especially the males, were showed different, delays in gait and slower gait, and like for example, the step cycle and the stride length. And when we treated with NAP, we actually corrected it. And then we looked also at motor activities. So we looked first of all at the hanging wire test and also the grip strength test. And what we saw again is that the males, the haploinsufficient males were slower, and they had less strength. And then when we treated with NAP, we corrected it. And this, if you remember, the motor cortex, the effect was more severe in the males, and this translates into a more severe effect on the motor function. And then we looked also at memory function. All the ADNP children are affected, cognitively affected, and we saw they have intellectual disability. And here in the mice, we tested object recognition, the ability to differentiate two different objects. And what we saw is that both males and females are affected, and in both sexes, this is corrected by NAP treatment. We also looked at social recognition. This was more affected in the female, corrected by NAP. Also at odor discrimination, again, affected in the female and corrected by NAP to a degree. And then we looked at social memory, the ability to remember a mouse that the mice had seen before. And this is also defective or impaired in both males and females and corrected in both males and females by NAP treatment. So if we take the whole story together, we actually see that in every test that we have performed, we saw an impairment. When we see an impairment in the children, we also see an impairment in the mouse. And in many cases, this is corrected by NAP treatment. And also, lastly, the bottom row of this table speaks about specific genes that have been changed in the spleens of the mice that, as a consequence of ADNP haploinsufficiency. And these same genes were changed as a consequence of ADNP mutations in the lymphoblastoid cells derived from patients. And in the case of the animals, we actually corrected it by NAP treatment. So in general, this is now ready for development into the clinic. And previous clinical studies of NAP, which we also call dovunetide, or now we call it CP201. So as dovunetide, it passed phase one clinical studies and showed no significant side effects. It then passed phase two efficacy studies in amnestic mild cognitive impairment, showing enhancements of visual memory and short-term memory. And then we also looked at the phase two efficacy studies in, when I say we, it's actually eminent physicians in the United States looked also at cognitive impairment associated with schizophrenia and demonstrated efficacy on activities of daily living and also on visual working memory. And this together shows that the compound is safe, well tolerated, and also shows efficacy on cognition, which is what is impaired in the ADNP children. So now Coronis Neurosciences has an exclusive license from Ramotet Tel Aviv University to develop the dovunetide, which is now called CP201, and we call it in the laboratory NAP, for the LDNP syndrome children. And I'm very happy to say that CP201 received orphan drug status in 2018, in February 2018, and it's ready to go on for clinical studies, and we have already a clinical plan. So thank you very, very much.